Say my name.
Yo, King, turn up the heat.
Many well-known brand names that we see every day are international companies. Because of this, a lot of products that we know and love actually have different names around the world. See how many brand names you can guess as we look through 15 famous brand names that are different abroad.
Quick question, though. What's this called?
Dr. Oetker, Cameo.
Pizza, pizza, going, Tommy, me so hungry.
We all remember that famous scene in Pulp Fiction in which John Travolta's character goes into detail about McDonald's quarter pounder with cheese. Because of the metric system in France, they call the quarter pounder a royale with cheese, a classic movie moment that is still quoted to this day.
You know what they call a quarter pounder with cheese in France.
And a similar reason to why Dr. Oetker's frozen pizzas are known by Cameo in Italy. Once Dr. Oetker had established itself as a big frozen pizza company, they wanted to expand their brand around the world. And where better to go to than Italy? It is the home of pizza, after all. Wanting to fit in with the local culture and language, Dr. Oetker changed its name to Cameo in order to sound more Italian. An advertising tool that a lot of companies have used to conquer the international market. Hellmann's Best Foods.
Mayo! I love mayo.
When it comes to condiments, especially mayo, many people's go-to brand is Hellmann's. The rich and creamy mayonnaise goes with all of our favorite meats and treats. For a big chunk of the world, including the UK, Europe, and most of the US, this famous mayo brand is known as Hellmann's. However, if you were to venture to Asia, as well as Australia and New Zealand, and states west of the Rockies, then you wouldn't find Hellmann's on the shelf, as the company is called Best Foods in that part of the world. You'll be forgiven if you don't notice that right away, as both mayos are packaged exactly the same way with the same colors and designs.
Now that just seems intentionally confusing.
Burger King, Hungry Jack's.
So what kind of a king are you?
Maybe he's a Burger King.
We all love a Whopper from time to time. However, if you happen to find yourself in Australia, then you won't be able to order the famous burger in a Burger King fast food restaurant. In fact, you won't even be able to find a Burger King. When Burger King was looking to expand its franchise into the Southern Hemisphere, it ran into a bit of a problem, as the name Burger King was already trademarked in Australia. Because of this, the fast food Burger King couldn't use their name and had to come up with something else. The name Hungry Jack's was settled upon. That famous Burger King logo and great tasting burgers are the same. It's just the name that's different.
I told you, we do things differently.
Dove. Galaxy.
I will give you this Dove bar if you do something for me.
During the 1960s, the UK released a velvety, smooth chocolate bar called Galaxy. The chocolate proved to be a huge success, so much so that it soon caught the eye of the Mars Corporation. Mars bought the rights to the chocolate in the 1980s and rebranded it as Dove in the US. But rather than change the name in the UK, they chose to keep the name Galaxy to please the chocolate diehard fans. Galaxy is still a bar of popular chocolate in the UK and is often voted in their top 10 most loved candies.
That's delicious.
Good.
Smarties, Rockets.
I didn't even know Smarties made a cereal.
They don't, it's just Smarties in a bowl with milk.
There are certain candies that instantly remind us of our youth, and Smarties are one of them. This multicolored candy always puts a smile on those that eat them. However, it may be interesting to know that a large part of the world doesn't call them Smarties, and they are known as Rockets instead. The reason for this is quite a simple one, as the UK, Canada, and Australia already have a candy called Smarties. So to avoid confusion, these little treats are called Rockets. A little fun fact for all candy lovers out there, the Smarties that these countries have are little candy-covered chocolates that were actually the inspiration for the original M&Ms.
I didn't know that.
Kraft Mac and Cheese, Kraft Dinner.
I've been skimming mac and cheese for 75 years.
I'm only 45.
I have another family.
Mac and Cheese has been delighting so many people for so many years, and a lot of people's favorite brand is Kraft Mac and Cheese. Once upon a time, Kraft Mac and Cheese was known as Kraft Dinner. However, in the US, Kraft rebranded it as Kraft Mac and Cheese, but not in Canada. In Canada, this dish is still called Kraft Dinner, or KD for short, and they actually love this comfort food much more than the US. In fact, Canadians buy over 50% more per year than Americans.
Where's my mac and cheese?
Doritos Cool Ranch. Cool American.
Of all the flavors, Cool Ranch is like, I couldn't have chosen a better Dorito.
What goes together better than ranch dressing and Doritos? However, if you were to cross the pond and ask for Cool Ranch Doritos, you will be met with a bemused stare rather than a tasty bag of chips. There are a few reasons for this. The main one is probably because ranch dressing isn't really that popular in Europe. So instead, these tasty corn chips are known as Cool American Doritos. In the UK, they go even further, as these Doritos are known as Cool Original Doritos.
So I scraped all the Cool Ranch off of 15 bags of Doritos.
You bringing him a bowl of powder?
Good humor, Walls.
I didn't see any Good Humor ice cream bars. Shall I add them to your shopping list?
You know what?
Good Humor is a brand that has become synonymous with great comfort food. However, if you're looking for an ice cream fix in the UK, then Good Humor won't do, as this brand is known as Walls. In fact, most of the world actually knows this brand as something completely different. In Asia, it's known as Quality Walls. In Bolivia, it's Breslers. In Mexico, it's Holanda. And in the Philippines, it's called Selecta. The reason for this is that Good Humor is owned by Unilever, who like to buy up local ice cream companies and rebrand them with their famous heart logo.
It's your go-go corporate takeover lifestyles that are driving out these mom-and-pop stores.
Danone. Danone.
You eat all my Danone yogurts!
I don't see your name on them!
This famous yogurt brand is known across the country as Danone, but for most of the world, it's Danone. Danone was created at the beginning of the 20th century when Dr. Isaac Carasso began producing yogurt. Once his yogurt became popular, Carasso named his new company Danone, which translates to Little Daniel, which was his son. Once the company became more popular, Danone looked to sell its products in the US, but was worried about the pronunciation problems that Danone might cause, so they decided to change the company name to Danone to avoid any possible confusion.
Ah, we wouldn't want that.
Rice Krispies, Rice Bubbles.
I use Rice Krispies. It adds crunch and it weighs nothing.
Rice Krispies have been many children's staple breakfast for decades. However, if you find yourself in the land down under, then be sure to ask for Rice Bubbles, as that is what they call them. Incidentally, it's not just Australia and New Zealand that have variations on Rice Krispies. In the UK, as well as Australia, New Zealand, Greece, and Italy, Coco Krispies are known as Coco Pops, even with a different mascot, Coco the Monkey. It seems that most countries have their own name for this classic cereal and its many variations.
Oh, okay, that's hard to keep track.
Diet Coke, Coca-Cola Light.
That Diet Coke, I think, just straight to my head. Woo!
You may think that a huge brand name such as Coca-Cola would be on this list. Well, even the kings of the soda world are subject to differences between countries and cultures. Diet Coke is possibly one of the more famous items that Coca-Cola has ever produced, even more so than the original Coke flavor. Americans went crazy for this low-sugar version of their favorite drink. However, in most parts of the world, you can't order a Diet Coke anywhere. That's because it is known as Coca-Cola Light. The reason that Coca-Cola gives for the name change is that a lot of countries around the world don't associate the word diet with low sugar or low calorie drinks. So they switched the name to Coca-Cola Light to avoid confusion.
Smart move, lad! That's using the old intellect!
DiGiorno Delizio.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, progress peaked with frozen pizza.
It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno. Since the 1990s, DiGiorno frozen pizzas have been a favorite in grocery stores across the country. Known for its rising crust, DiGiorno is so proud of their pizzas that they say it's just as good as any takeout pizza.
Huh. Bold claim.
However, when DiGiorno wanted to sell their product across the border in Canada, DiGiorno wasn't the name they used. Instead, they were sold in Canada under the name Delicio. They still have the same pizzas, boxes, and even their advertising slogan. It was just the name that changed. Recently, Kraft sold the brand to Nestle, and while there may be a new owner for this frozen pizza, it doesn't look like Canada will be getting a new pizza name, as they are staying with Delicio. Three Musketeers, Milky Way.
What's dessert?
Bite-sized Three Musketeers.
Brace yourselves, as this entry is about to get a little complicated. If you've ever had a Three Musketeers chocolate bar, then you know how good it is. The bar of milk chocolate covering whipped nougat comes right out of chocolate heaven. However, if you take a trip to the UK, you will have to look for a Milky Way instead. Both chocolate bars are identical. The only difference is the wrapper. Here is, however, where things get a little complicated. If you are still in the UK, maybe seeing the British Milky Way makes you want a US Milky Way. So you start looking over the candy shelves for it, but you won't find it. In Britain, a Milky Way is called a Mars bar. That's right, Milky Way is a Mars bar, and a Three Musketeers is a Milky Way. But even more than that, all these chocolate bars are owned and manufactured by Mars Incorporated. We are sure this is just some big prank designed to mess with us.
My head hurts.
Blaze Walkers.
We're on strike.
Hunger strike.
You're eating potato chips.
Chips don't count.
Whether it's as a quick snack or a part of lunch, Lay's chips have been a winner for both adults and children alike for years. Each year, the list of flavors seems to grow, and we learn to love Lay's more and more. Everyone has their favorite flavor of chips, but if you pop across the pond to the UK, then you may be in for a bit of a shock if you try to grab a packet of Lay's. In the UK, Lay's chips are known as Walkers, and chips are known as crisps, and French fries are chips. Doubly confusing. The reason that Lay's are Walkers in the UK is quite simple. PepsiCo, which owns Lay's, bought out the UK company Walkers and added them to their brand. While PepsiCo did try and rebrand these snacks as Lay's, the Walkers name was already a popular brand in the UK, so PepsiCo decided to leave the name alone and stick with Walkers. Everything else about these chips is the same. The packaging, logo, and the same great taste.
Now you're making me hungry.
KFC, PFK.
I brought fried chicken.
Biscuit. First dibs.
Kentucky Fried Chicken is one of the most recognizable brands in the world, and everyone enjoys tucking into this finger-licking good chicken. However, if you live in Quebec, Canada, then you will find it all a bit different. Because of the language laws and restrictions in the French-speaking Canadian province, all businesses have to advertise their companies in French first.
If you wish to avoid prosecution, I would advise that you comply with our language laws.
So KFC had to change their name to PFK, Poulet Frites Kentucky. But it may be interesting to know that in France, KFC is called KFC. It seems like the French speakers from France don't mind using the English name for this famous fried chicken company. Treat yourself to more and tap that screen for our next great video. Checking us out for the first time? Then take a second to hit that subscribe button and ring that bell to join our notification squad.